We are no longer in the bush. Because if we were in the bush, all this nonsense would not happen.
Testifying on oath, Professor Nyeko Penmogi, the acting chairperson of Uganda Land Commission, told the committee that there was no public involvement in the allocation of at least 50 acres of land to private investors, as they used an internal advert that was placed on the notice board. This was against the resolution at a commission meeting that the land be advertised publicly.
Presented to us. We all agreed that as a commission, that this land should be advertised. And it was internally advertised. Internal advert.
Mr. Chairman, where is the internal advert? In the ministry? In the country? In parliament? Is it a job that you are internal advertising? You know, where is the advert?
Well, you see, as I said, we as the commission wanted this to be advertised broadly. But we found that the advertisement was internal on the notice board of the commission.
What informed that decision, and who were you targeting? Two, did you actually internal advertise? Three, you said you were invited when there was a list. Is that when you learned there was a process of selling?
This did not sit well with the legislators, who questioned how public land can be advertised internally. They demanded to know why the law is not being followed in the case of individual applicants who have to identify the land themselves.
The law that governs is the PPDA.
What does it say? You are the secretary, you are the acting secretary. Today, if there was a land to allocate, like I know there is, tell me what happens. You don't know?
Is that Uganda Land Commission does not actually advertise. Information is kept secretly to themselves, their friends. If I know there is land and I'm a member of ULOC, I call a friend. I say, please come to our notice board. That's what they call internal advert. Eh? Yes, I know they don't have. It is just not there.
Legislators on the committee, Asman Basalirwa of Bujiri Municipality and Dixon Kateshumbwa of Shema Municipality, accused the commission of doing a disservice to the country by ignoring the laid out procedures while allocating the Nakanaguru land to private investors.
So whoever has been in the commission for that time, and this is how public matters have been run.
Yet if you look at the letters of allocation, actually, they are dated to February, way after the minister had given you.
Committee members accused the commission of defying President Museveni's directive not to allocate land to private investors, save for the Uganda Heart Institute and the Internal Medicines of Virginia.
His Excellency says that regarding the Nakanaguru land, I have seen the list of companies to whom the commission has allocated land. I therefore need to be convinced that the companies you have allocated land have both the technical and financial capacity to develop it and are not mere speculators. I also need to be informed about the projects they are going to undertake and what strict conditions have been given to them by government to ensure compliance.
Uganda Land Commission officials further invited trouble when Acting Secretary Nyumba revealed that the commission does not have an inventory of all the land under its management.
How did these 15 get to know that there was land in Uganda Land Commission for them to apply and for you to grant them? How come me I didn't know about it? And these 15 got to know about it? What is the magic and science there?
What informs your decision to say, let me give whoever, regardless of the businesses that they are doing?
With that, we were now called when there are lists of people have applied for the land, and we proceeded. It might have also been an oversight on our part, but that's what happened.
The ad hoc committee also interacted with the Minister for Local Government, Raphael Majeze, who distanced the ministry from involvement in allocation of Naguru Nakawa land, saying it ceased to be responsible for land at Naguru in 2014. He, however, assured the committee that the government is committed to paying 17.9 million shillings to each of the 1,971 former tenants on the Nakawa Naguru land that were valued by the chief government valuer following a cabinet directive.
From the time Kampala City Council became Kampala Capital City Authority, managed under its own law, with its own minister, with its own departments under the president, it's under the office of the president, we handed over the project.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news.